Welcome, everyone. It's an exceptional pleasure for me and honor to introduce Jean-François Renaud from the Babin Renaud Architects, who has been a friend and colleague in Paris for us for now almost 3 years, together with Gaël Breton, who is here as well in the audience, equally a great friend of ours and great teacher, both of them. I was thinking of what his architecture, their architecture conveys, and I find their work to be silent, precise, deceptively simple, and discreetly enchanting. It is interesting how, even though we are back in Texas, that John Ockman at some point called the intellectual backwaters of America, that among others, not only we have this kind of relationships in the last few years, but our dear and highly appreciated teacher, professor at the school, and who had been a student of ours 20 years ago, exactly when Babin Renaud and Architects was founded, Charles Di Piazza was the first student who worked in their office as an intern at the very beginning of them. Perhaps it would be best to read the self-description and goals of their architecture. Éric Babin and Jean-François Renaud are calmly following a singular pathway, delivering rigorous and engaged products freed from the tyranny of fashion. Holding dear to the concept that a building should occupy a proper place in its setting, while perfecting new architecture types derived from analyzing each program. Their production, architectural creation, is huge. In the last less than 20 years, they have built 20 major buildings. So, in fact, more than one a year, always in the public domain, mainly public or social housing, as it is called in France, but also cultural centers and various projects that in France are submitted to open competitions, which allows young firms, young architects, to come very quickly to the fore when they are good. And the best architecture, actually, in France, which is social housing, has this quality because it is a result of competitions where the best usually win. Babin and Renaud Architects have won numerous awards. Only last year, I counted 7, among others, the latest, which is the prize for the best public housing in France. They have been nominated for the Miss Van der Rohe Prize, which is a European prize, award for the Chicago Ateneo Museum of Architecture and Design for a mixed-use building, award for a cultural center, housing, awards for housing at the Parc de Canopia in Nantes, because they really build perhaps mostly in Paris, but we build a lot all over France. They, as Jean-François told me, whom we had really to insist for almost 4 months to cajole him into speaking. Among others, as he said, Eric Babin and Jean-François Renaud do not teach their architecture, do not show their architecture to their students, because they are against making little Babins and little Renaults. So this is a big exception, because among us here are 21 French students, their students, students with whom we work together with our Austrian students. And so, but since it is 5,000 miles, more or less, distant from the school, he thought that, well, maybe he could make this exception. So after these few words, very few words, there will be so much more to say, but it's more interesting to hear Jean-François himself. Please join me to greet Jean-François Renaud.
Thank you. And I have to push the button. Okay, so it works? Yeah. Well, Danilo, thank you. Thank you. It's for those kind. It works or it's there is little noise? I don't know. Those kind words. I hope the assembly won't be disappointed. So because it. I have a big goal now after your talk.
It's all derived from your work, you know.
Excuse me, can
yeah.
I think these are either too close.
Ah.
So maybe, sorry. Okay. Try now?
Yeah, I have two, three, four. Madonna.
It's still not good. Hold on.
It's still not good.
Yeah.
Okay. It's my heart. I'm a bit stressed, I must confess, because my English is not so so good. So just before beginning, if I don't find my words, I hope the project will talk for me. It doesn't work yet. maybe. Oui, mais il veut l'enregistrer.
The one I use is the one you have on the belly button.
Ah. Maybe it's my shirt.
Maybe
it's
just
get rid of
the top one and use the bottom.
Yeah.
Oh, maybe here, no? Wow. yeah.
Here?
You hear me? No.
Move the bottom
up.
The
bottom one, because I think this one.
That's the bad guy, but that's the one that you can. This is just goes into the camera.
Yeah, but if you don't have
I can speak loud.
There's not gonna be
okay, so just this one?
Yeah, that one.
And this one we can take away.
Okay.
Okay, maybe it's okay like this.
Or you don't have a... I can maybe speak. isn't it a micro?
No, that's the camera.
Okay.
Maybe just leave it here.
Maybe we can begin like this?
Yes.
Can you hear me? Okay. So, yes, well. Thank you for the university to invite me. It's I'm very flattered to be here, and for your hospitality, for all the week that we spend here with the students, and to make this lecture. Thank you to Elisabeth, Danilo, all my friends from here now. And yes, actually I have almost two lives in Paris, one life of professor with teaching, and one life as architect. And as Danilo said, I usually refuse to show or to make a lecture in Belleville to show our work, because I work with Eric Babin, who is also professor in Belleville. So you see, when you show something, it's a kind of terrible thing. But maybe, yes, for here, I think it's the end of the semester for you. So maybe it's okay, so you won't be too shocked with my project. And I think all the other American students, it's passed. So I have three years of American students. So now I think I can show our last work. So I just like this. I organized the lecture with a little parcours, a little walk around France. To show you our six last project, and which is six specific and different project and adventure, because as Danilo say, for us a project is issue of the tension between a site and a program, and a site which is specific, which is existent before we come. And it's a kind of thing with a history, how to set in a site, how to set a new building, a new uses in site, and a reflection more theoric and more abstract on what should be a new program without site, and how this program can be merged in the site. So I thought it was interesting to show you six different situations of projects, because for each project it's one site, one program, and so we make six different strategy of projects. And so I have to be quick, because I think the there is many things to show you. So the first one is a program of it's one of our last project. We just finished it 3 months ago after 10 years of studies. And it's a site just in the suburb of Paris, in the south, in an heterogeneous urban fabric with houses. Maybe I can show you. Yeah, here. With houses, mainly houses, sorry. A cemetery and some buildings with seven or eight levels. And we had to think about the installation of a new school for dance, theater, and music, which is quite a big program for this city and a big mass of square meter for this district. And the question was, in this kind of fabric, how can we install there a new public building, which is a school, and how we can fabric specific public space for this building. So the work begin with a reflection about solid and void. The student will recognize some word. Solid and void, that mean that we concentrate all the program in one solid, one cube, the red cube here, to liberate or to build a void just in front. And this void is the esplanade, it's a specific public space for the new school. So you see in this diagram, so we concentrate all the program in this white cube here to liberate this void just in front of it. The program was very interesting because there is several different kind of space, and we analyzed the program with a non-functional term. That means that we class all the different rooms by surface, small, medium, large, by light, dark or bright, by proportion or geometry, square or rectangle, by acoustic needs, and then we, the project is a kind of try to make a kind of society of all those with all those little spaces with different dimension, and to organize them in a system in the cube, and we organize them with different strips, with a first strip facing the esplanade just behind with a little space, then a strip here to the circulation, a strip here to the services, and the last strip here for the main theater hall that this school needs. So it's a kind of, you know, millefeuille. I don't know how you call that. It's a okay. It's
layered
a
cake.
Yeah, a layered cake. It's a famous cake in France. And after doing that, of course, you see it's also a system of structure, because you have small space and big space, or small dimension and big portée, a big span. And after doing that, we have to organize the progression between the public space to the inside of the building by a kind of promenade transversal axe here, which is the main entrance of the building. You can see that in the section here. And to find the good scale of this cube in the neighborhood, we thought that it was interesting to put some of the program underneath, so that the esplanade is not just an esplanade, it's the roof of the program. So the program is building the public space for us. And then you see we make some patio here to give light to the basement. And then you have the axe, the progression axe from the public space to the main theater room at the end here, and the different layer that you can see here. So we have a little walk around the building. So this is the esplanade. Maybe I can go quickly because there is many, many photographs. So the esplanade and the relation between the street, the new esplanade, the patio, and the white cube here. You see the phi, it's the patio here, which is detached, the white cube, from the city. This is the same view. And here you see that the main hall, the main entrance, is digged into the white cube. But the cube for himself is made from white steel panels. And the only thing which is good is the main entrance hall. So this is the axe of progression from the outdoor space or the outdoor esplanade to the main
lobby.
The main lobby. And then after here, behind this door, this wood door, the main theater room. So you see that this door, this wood panel, can be slipped, I don't know. So we can connect directly through the building, the main theater room to the public space. So that was very important for us, that we can experiment in the space, the deepness of the cube. And so when you are inside, you see that here is the main hall looking to the theater hall. So this is the scale of somebody in the hall to the theater hall. Inside of this building, we have several little space or medium space. And we have a specific work with the plaster to configure the acoustic quality of each space. So we have one space for each instrument. So each space has a specific work in his geometry for each instrument, that we can have the best acoustic with the plastic with the plaster work. So there is also a dance school. So this is the dance class. And here I come back to the envelope of the cube, which is made with a steel panel, as I say, and glass, which is at the same level, exactly. And then also tube of aluminium white at the same level. I don't know comment on dit le nu.
Plane.
Okay. So it was very important for us that the to have this, how could I say, maybe this geometric abstraction of the elevation to work this building as just a surface, just change the texture of the surface, and have just this main entrance that's digging. So this is Eric. I put this slide that you can see him. And you see this last picture show one thing that we believe in, is that we every time try to make that the functional use is not obvious from the outside. So we want that our building not be a show off of the inside, but just suggesting what's happened inside. There is life inside.
Yes.
Yeah, that the building suggests what there is life inside. So you can see there's activities, the light is going on, etc. But it's not a functionalist facade. So the facade has his own expression, and the expression is the expression of a public building. It's not the expression of any functionment or so. It's for us, it's very different, and it's for the it's one of the points that we develop in many projects. The second situation is a cultural center in Le Mans, and it's a historic site. Le Mans is a little town, it's a middle town, I can say, in the west of France. And we are very lucky because the site is just amazing. There is the Cathedral du Mans just here. You can see on the picture here. There is the court law here. This is the main place, the public place of the city here. There is a beautiful garden just behind the project, which is here. A beautiful garden à la française, very composed with beautiful trees. And so it was a site just amazing. We were just in the center of the city. And the program was also very exciting because, is also very exciting, because the goal was to make a synergy between different expression of art. So the city wanted to that people going to cinema can meet people going to theater, and can meet people going to exhibitions. So it's a cultural center, and the goal is to make a synergy between cinema, theater, and exhibition. To go back to the site, one of the main goals that we read at the beginning is that our site was able to connect two major public space in the city, which is this place, Place des Quinconces, the main place of the city with the outdoor market, etc., and the garden behind here. And so we imagine that the project and the program can link those two public space by a public promenade or public space too. And then in the way of find the good way to set the project in the site, there is geometric work on the site to find the good adjustment of each party. So this diagram is related to this one, because on this site, we decide to split the program in different pieces. that everyone can be everyone. Every piece of the puzzle can be autonomous, can have his own life. So the theater can open when he wants. The theater which is public can open when he wants. The cinema which is private can have different hours of functionment. And we decide to have the theater here directly on the main public space, and the cinema a little bit behind, that the public equipment, which is the theater, have the have the main facade on the public space. So he win the but whatever. And at the and behind here, in this gray rectangular, we have all the exhibition place, which is a low building, who is tending to make the fourth side of the garden. So you can see here the organization, and this allowed us to have in between space to make the synergy. So the goal of this project is to make the synergy of different type of program with the in-between space between them. And it's a kind of autonomy of each part, of each piece, but it's a unity of the cultural center made by the square geometry of the whole. So you see here the dispositive when you see the theater on the right here, and the cinema little behind, and the transparency to the garden at the back.
I don't know if we can read the
naturally. Yeah. Okay. So just one word on the ground floor here, where you can see the in-between space here, where we connect visually the main lobby of the multiplex cinema and the main lobby of the theater here. And you see on the section that this public space in between, which is here, is the roof of the main theater hall of the multiplex, which is underneath. So it's quite the same dispositive of Vanve, that we try to have a slab of program, and then to have just emerging the main piece of the program. So we can connect by the slab all the services, but we have the public entrance that is autonomized. So you see there the section of the theater here, and the section of the multiplex here. Maybe I have not that much time to explain you. And then here is the exhibition hall, and actually there is three different space. There is an exhibition hall, but there is also a little movie theater, and a polyvalent space, and there is a very good surprise during the chantier, the time of construction, that the mayor decided to make his the council room in the project. So this is fantastic, I think, because it's not only the cultural center, but the politic center now, and it's also where the democracy is going on. So I think it's a good thing. So let's have a walk around the building. So you see here the theater with the main hall here under the same roof of the cinema here. The cinema is just one block of stone floating over the public floor, the public entry, yeah. And the main room of the theater is like a balcony on the city. And when you are in this balcony, you can see, of course, the people that are going to cinema, but you can see also the cathedral. So we're going further. So we are on the esplanade under the Unitarian roof. And then this is the space in between when we have the garden back and we are looking at the old Le Mans, the old city. And you see here, this is a new space so we that the this project creates. It was not in the program, so it's a creation of the project. And it's a public space that you can see people going back from the movie by this stairs. You can see the bar of the movie theater, not the movie theater, of the movie, of the theater, sorry, here. And you can see the old city of Le Mans there. For the theater, some view from the theater. So this is the main lobby. When you can see the roof, the Unitarian roof, and the block of stone of the cinema. The theater room with these wood flakes that make the light inside. This is the theater room's view from the technical part, from the stage, in fact, because it's very technical. And then for the cinema, there is a main hall for the cinema here. And we try to imagine what could be a multiplex just near a cathedral, which is an interesting question. And we invent a dispositif that we have one main hall, which is an horizontal hall, very transparent, that you see there is no structure outside, there is only glass. And in this hall, you just find tickets and restaurants. And to find popcorn, you have to go down. So at the level of the city, you just find tickets and restaurants. And after you go down with the stair, and then you have all the function of a multiplex. I mean, Coke, popcorn, etc. And then you go on down again. And you find all the different rooms. So the multiplex is one under the block of stone. You have one main hall, which is very horizontal and transparency. And then you go to a slot, vertical, to find the different theater room. On the last part, on the part of the side of the garden, we find those three spaces that I talked before. So this is the exhibition space. This is the major space, I can say. I don't know, the county space. And to have the fourth side of the garden, to have a very low building, we put those space engraved in the earth, not the earth, but sunken. Yeah, and you see that the space function with lights from the left, which is the garden here, and light from the right, which is patio, that goes to the that goes deep to the ground. So this is the facade of garden side, which is in I see Corten, it's more. I don't. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Different wood to the patio here. And the roof of those three space, very low, is made with a new terrace that is on the garden. And it works very well now. So you are all lovers of Le Mans that going here at night to make appointments. So, So that was Le Mans. And now I'm going to talk. I don't know what time is it. Okay. I want to go on with four projects of social housing or mixed-use projects. And I wanted to begin by this project of Nantes. Danilo told two words about it. It's a project in the suburb of Nantes. It's a program of 50 units of public housing with a mixity of inhabitants, old people, families, singles. And the question here for us was to find an alternative, not for only for us, but only for all the city, to find an alternative to the individual housing development. So to find a way to inhabit the periphery of the city, but not with just houses, but with a kind of collective unit. So a reflection about what could the people share in this place. So because it's not a landscape, but it's a kind of park or and what can people share in this kind of place to live with because 50 units, it's 150 persons, 150 inhabitants in France, it's about three inhabitants by unit. So what those 150 persons can share in this place. And I showed you this project just after Le Mans because it's not the same program, of course, but maybe the strategy is not so far, because we answer telling that they can share a void, like a big patio, which can make a symbolic appropriation of the whole the whole unity. So it's also a reflection on fragmentation and unity. Fragmentation, this is the houses, the units. So it's talk about intimacy, how everyone in this dispositif can find a link to a shared space, which is this interior space, and the outdoor public space or landscape. So we install every unit between this patio, which is in section link the car park, which is open air car park, to the sky, and that allowed to that every unit have a view on the collective space here and a public or landscape outdoor. After that, this collective space is connected to the landscape by different slope in this figure. So this figure, this architectural set is made by four pieces around this common patio. So you can see the map here. So and of course in this architectural set, we alternate different way of inhabit here. So you have houses, but not houses, but quite houses, duplex with a garden and private access. And we have a little there and there, two little collective housing for the small units, but the big units are thinking like a house, row house. And then this is the main access to the whole unity with one main hall here. So the 150 inhabitants can find the letterbox here and can share a space together upstairs. And you can see here that we have a void between a slab, which is the new sol, the new ground, thank you. The new ground and the original ground. And this was very important for us because in this project, we think that we offer a new ground to those 150 people, and they share the new ground, but it's a different level than the ground floor. And these stairs can a kind of a threshold between the public space of the city and the shared space of the inside of the figure. So you see here the car park, which is outdoor and with light, and the main hall entrance, and then you go in the figure. So this is from out where you you can see that we have a slope here, but we have also hole in you see here and here. We make hole to connect. I'll just come back 2 seconds. Here you see that each stair is connected visually to the stair in front of him. And so you have a work of geometry in this organization that at each house you have a slope that cross all the dispositif. And so you are inside the patio, but you can see always outside the landscape. And so this is the hole here and here that you can see in this building. After that, it was social housing in Nantes with very low budget. So we have a specific work on this project just to have a frame of aluminium around the windows. So this is the scale of the unit windows. And this is the scale, which is bigger, and it's very important, of the common space. Of the stairs and the common space. And we alternate different size of window on just a wall of concrete, and that's all. So it's a very very cheap architecture. So this is some view from the different place in the. This is a view from outside. So another project, other situation, another strategy. We will go back to Paris with always public social housing, but in a specific site here, which is in between the périphérique here. This is the ville of Saint-Ouen in the north of Paris, and this is the Paris intramuros. And you have here the what we call boulevard extérieur. So it's just where we have a new tram line here. And Paris always has a big issue with the periphery because it generates a kind of no man's land between Paris intramuros and the other cities all around. And the city of Paris want to go back here, so want all those space here are in reconquête, are in
reclaiming,
are reclaimed by the city. So the city decide to install here new inhabitants and also new public equipment. And we have in this project different public equipment. We have a public library, we have a nursery, we have a school dojo and dance, we have a social care. So we have many equipment. And that means that now this 100 and I don't remember, but maybe 100 meter of street is really alive. And before the project, it was just a no man's land. it's alive because you have all the two first floor are the public equipment that the city wanted to be here. So we had to work on this project and to find the way to organize the different uses between the different public equipment and the inhabitants. So we organized that with a slab of two level with all public equipment, and they have all the main facade on the main street here, giving the main facade on the main street for the public equipment, and to split the line in four blocks, so three in between space, that allowed us to have the hall for the inhabitants at the backside of the line. So we use this dispositif to cross the building through the building to find the scale for the inhabitant hall at the backside. So you can see that in the ground floor here, when you see that this is a slab that inhabitants go to their home by this space, find the patio here and find the hall here. Same for here, so that here all the other facades are the new public equipment. So that was our answer to the mixed use building. And so that was a different situation, different strategy. Another thing is that this site has two sides very different. One west is very noisy and very very pollution, lots of
polluted,
much lot polluted. And on the other side, it's face a garden, so it's a kind of genus site with a two side very antagonist. And so we work you can see the four the fourth place, the four blocks and the three in between space, and then we have on the main facade on the boulevard this expression with this flat but with many layers. So we have three layers of glass to protect from the noise and the pollution. But on the other one, the project is much more open, yeah, maybe. And you can find all those balconies facing the garden. So this is view from the slab of the public equipment. This is the library. And the dance room and an apartment. And maybe I just say one word about the organization of the apartment. We have with this dispositif of plot with the slot here, we have all the apartment with the angle. So it's not the, maybe it's not this one. Yes, we have all the apartment with two orientation. So we made the living room in the angle here, here and here, not here. No, it's not the good. It's the last. It's the last level. So, no interest. So and for the two last project, maybe I'm too long. Yes, I think I'm gonna run. We are still in Paris, but a different district. So it's not an urban periphery, but it's two projects not far from the school of Belleville. And as someone know here, the neighborhood of Belleville is, we call that a faubourg. So it's very particular in Paris, the condition of faubourg. So it's a kind of strong urban structure with a public space, the streets, very very strict, but division by lots, by small lots often, and sometimes very long, narrow but deep lots. And this urban structure allowed a progressive densification since the 19th. So it's very interesting to work there because you can find a kind of freedom to play with the rules and it's not an homogeneous as homogeneous as Haussmann. So there is a lot of diversity and liberty, a kind of liberty in the building. So the first experience here was a student housing with it's a small one when you when you compare to here. We have 30 units, so it's a little baby. But you see the fabric of the Faubourg. It's only little babies, and sometimes big one from the 70s, but lots of times it's really tiny slots. And we have these slots very narrow and very deep to install there these 30 units, so 30 students. And so it was a goal because the threat is so small and very difficult to access there for the contractors. And we decide to organize the projects with all the room, the main of the room distributed by a coursive. It's outdoor corridor. Right. Yeah, it's an outdoor corridor. So all the rooms, the student rooms, have an exterior prolongation to the garden, because we make a little garden inside the slot here. And we organize a promenade from the ground floor to a shared terrace at the last level, going by this coursive, so in all the buildings. So to find a kind of verticality in the living together. So we have on the ground floor common space for the litter box, the vélo, the bicycle, and blah blah blah, and we have those coursives, those outdoor corridors around this tiny garden here, and on the last floor we find the common terrace. And I wanted to show you this project, so because it's a house for students, but we choose to use the wood here. And so the occasion to talk about the materiality of the project, because for each project we try to find the good way for build it, and what can make sense. And at the end, I think that it's not only the tension between a site and a program, but it's also the materiality, which is here. And it's there is three main pool of reflection in our project. Is what should be the good way of set architecture in a city? What should be the ideality of the program? And what is the right way to build it? And here the answer was the wood, because it's so tiny and so difficult to access. So we wanted to have a chantier, a construction without concrete, which is just a goal in France, because we are really the country of the concrete. And it's very difficult to build in wood, which you cannot imagine. It's amazing. And then we decide that the wood was the good answer for this scale of building and for this situation of the slot. And when we decide after to use the wood, we use the wood for structure, for the floor, and for also the facade.
and it's quite a discovery. So each project is an occasion to discover and to draw the mise en œuvre, so the all the details, which is good for this material that we choose. But we don't have one material, you see. I think our choice of materials is really linked to the question of the site and the program each time. So you see the outdoor corridors there and the students arriving here. And the main hall is a tiny main hall. There is a 30 letterbox here. And then the terrace on the last floor here, and a different level, another level here. And this is the, we call that cursive, but I don't know what is your word. It's outdoor corridor, outdoor corridor, maybe? Mm-hmm. Yeah? Catwalk? No. Okay. And yes, what I'm, another thing, another reason that we choose the wood is that the wood can be prefabricated in a shop. Okay, in a shop, in a factory, yeah. And also all the, so we work on this idea of prefabrication, and so all the pieces of the building was arriving just like a model, and it's very quick to mount it. But also the bathroom was prefabricated, so it was a kind of a Lego. Everything is going, and it's the. Was very easy to build it. So you see the building in the context of the Rue des Cascades. This is Rue des Cascades. And finally, the last one, which is just at. Sorry?
The best in France.
The best in France, yes. The Écart d'Argent one, which is, we are very lucky and very happy and proud. So I think I have to run now. And just one word about the site. You know, our school is here. So this is our square with our cafe here. And we were very lucky to win this competition because we have to build on this site, which is amazing, which is a perfect triangle in the city. Very beautiful, and we have this tip of the triangle, which is the south tip, and this street is going up, so it's like a pro. Je l'avais regardé pourtant ce mot. a prow, like a prow on the city. So proud of the prow. Well, donc, no, really, it's a site. Really, we were very lucky to have the opportunity to work on this site. It's a very small site. There is 18 units, and local for activity on the ground floor. And you see the triangle here with all this geometry resolution. I'm really fascinated by this picture. And another thing, it is one of the most dense districts of Paris. So for example, our projects here on this lot, we have a density then it's I think it's 5.5, which is my for it will we'll talk for French students, I think. And cost de 5.5. So it's really, really, it's really dense, but it's just only six level. And this is Paris. So this is in Paris. This type of we call that an îlot. So this kind of block, this kind of block can make density with not so high building. But to make that with good units and to make that habitable is quite a goal. So that was our goal, to make a good inhabitation here in this kind of density and this kind of geometry. So how to build in this triangle with this strange geometry, very urban. So it's also for us, always the geometry of the site is a way of talking with history. So the way that the building finds his place is a way of comfort history sometimes, or to dialogue with history, because we are only architects, we are not the urbanism, the urbanist of all the districts, so we have to work with and to confirm and or to work with, yeah, to confirm. So it was quite fun to design this project, also with this little pick, like a mini flat iron, but it's in aluminium. And also, well, you understood that we wanted to build the pick, the tip, to respect the triangle, but we wanted also to link the courtyard, which is very tiny, to the public space, and to open, to link, and to join the entirety of the block to the public space. And we make that on this side because the light is coming here, and also because you have a street here, and so the slot here make the end of the Rue Vaucouleur, which is here. So this urban architectural setup make this organization for the different floor, and it's quite rational because we at this time again work with a strip of different functions. So we have the strip of the main room here, which can find the view and the sun, and the orientation to the public space. Then we have the strip of the kitchen and the bathroom here that are oriented to the courtyard and to the outdoor corridor. So we can find light for each bathroom, which is really a goal in Paris for that kind of density. And then we use the stairs and the lifts to make verticality and to answer to the building here, and to find this. So the triangle geometry make that this space is open to the street. So it's a geometric figure that solve the urban triangle and the habitability of the units. I think after, yeah. So you see the slope here. We take the stair, and we see the outdoor corridor, and then. In this picture we have just here. So for us it was very important that everyone, when he go back home, can situate himself in the city. In the city, that means here between the public space and the courtyard. So when you go back home, you experiment the deepness of the city and this dispositif that creates public space and shared space. And it's not the same scale, it's not the same units and the same geometry, but it is quite the same dispositif than Nantes. Or we want to install each unit, each habitation, between a public space and a shared space, and with a trajectory to go there. So with a different threshold to get from the public space to threshold, sorry.
from the public space to the space of intimacy. So after, and I have to finish with that, the question of for this project, we thought a lot about the question of the materiality, and the materiality is just a window, and it's a specific window because it's an urban window. It's not a window facing the sea or the mountain. It's facing other buildings and other inhabitants, so because Paris is a dense city. And so it's a window vertical because most of light can come through. And it's a window that you can use a shutter, open, closed, or in between. And the way that you use the shutter will change the facade of the building. And it was one thing that we wanted really to do is that the uses of the inhabitants can change the volume and the appearance of the building, but not showing what's happened inside. So it's the same theme that for the other project. This window is not specific in function of the space behind. So it's the same window for every space. So it's not a functional, it's not a functionalist window. It's not a window for each type of use, because in this in these units we don't know what is the use. You know, in France we make public social housing like that, but we don't know the inhabitants who will be allowed to live in. So we have to think that what we are doing is for everybody. And everybody doesn't mean for a medium human being. Everybody, for us, that means that everybody can appropriate the space and make him make the space for himself. So we cannot discuss with the client. We don't know who will live here. So we try to make the space as capable as possible, so that can be appropriate by everyone in with all the differences that exist. So after that, this is the way we think about this facade. So it's a kind of not generic, but it's a kind of urban facade, but make for inhabitants. And so you see the, well, just one word for the aluminium. It was quite the same idea to building changing in the time, because this material, which is anodized aluminium, kept the light of the site, not only the light of the sun, but also the light of the clouds and the light of the city. Because at night it's there is red light, there is lots of activities in this district, and this material kept the light and the colors, and it's not reflecting, it's just the colors. So it was the same idea that this building, very simple, can change with the uses of the inhabitant and the uses of the public space around. And that's what we'll see. What we will see here. So it's day and night, and everybody's sleeping. So everything is closed. And this is another view when you see where you see the vertical stair here, and it's night. This is at night, of course. And this is different view. Why you can see the building changing. Well, it's not so convincing, but I think this picture is maybe not so convincing, but
in the street, it's really true that the beginning is changing all the time. So this is this was the last my last picture. I hope it was clear. well, I think if you have question about what I said or about my work. Thank you.
So the detail that I missed saying is that Eric Babin and Jean-François have been together since working together since the first year of architecture throughout, and they are not even married.
Yeah, that was actually that was my conclusion, and because I didn't remember, but yes, I was just wanted to notice that and to say that this work we're doing the two of us, but more than two of us, because in the office we are between 10 and 20, and there is armies of bureaux d'études, but. I wanted to say to the students that I met Eric at 18 years old on the bench in Belleville, and many years after, and we made all our studies together and all those projects together, and I wanted just to say we are waiting for you now, and go on, it's your time. Thank you. Do you have questions? Or yeah, question. Yeah, I say always we because it's me and Eric, but because we discuss a lot about all those questions, and I think it's a very good one. And we don't think that a building has to be similar to the other, and that a new building between two other buildings should merge the two different materiality. And we are thinking differently. We are thinking that we are building now, and the architect on the right was building at his time, and on the left on his time. And what does it mean to build now? And I say that because now we have different technique for building, and different goals, because there are many goals. There is thermic goals, there is economic goals. So we have to deal with our context. But for me, the context is not only the building around. The context is the economy. What does it mean to build? With who are the builders? In which society all that can be built? And this is the context for me. And I think to be right with the context is not just to take the material that just are around and to use it. To be right with the context is maybe to say, well, he was right at his time, and the other one was right at his time. So maybe to be right is to be right now when you are building your own building. So, for example, this one, you know, now in Paris, we the goal of thermic is very high, and it's not possible to make isolation by the inside. So to build
in brick or in stone, supposed to build a wall of stone, then the isolation, and then the structure. So it's very difficult and very expensive. And we don't have money to make those wall in stone just on the facade to be okay with the right and the left. So we have to invent the new way of thinking the materiality, maybe, but still still in the perspective to be right and in the sight. I don't know if it's a good answer. For your question? Well, that's a very interesting one also. And I didn't talk about that, but we think a lot of well, we believe that a building, if he's right now, if he's really right, maybe he will have a long life. But to have a long life, maybe it means that the building can accept changing inside and can allowed to change and to be upset, update. Merci. To be update in the future, and for us, this question to be update in the future for a building is specifically a question of structure and of technical equipment, and we believe that. To have a right building with a long life is a building with a structure that is thought to be a structure that can allow different uses. For example, for the project for Le Mans, you remember the cultural center? We had two different programs, one theater and one multiplex. And we had this reflection that the theater is a very stable program in our society. You see, stable because we had for many years and centuries the organization of the theater is approximately the same. You have the seat and the visitors, you have the stage, you have so it's very stable. And in the towns, the theater are very stable. It's very rare that you destruct a theater. But on the other way, the multiplex and the movie theater, we don't know at all if in 20 years we will still have movie theater like that. We don't know. Maybe everybody will see the movie at home. Really, I don't know. So we have two programs with two future, very different. One very stable and one very unknown. And so we had all the reflection, all the design of the structure was related to this question, because so the theater is very stable in structure, so well, it can be updated for all the technique mechanism, but the structure of the theater is very specific and very stable in the building, so it's concrete, it's a very definitive, and it will maybe one day make a beautiful ruin. I don't know. On the other end, for the multiplex, it's structured just with points, and all the goal was to make the structure that can allow the most future use, so they can change the use of the multiplex. They can broke all the different rooms and make just one big museum if they want. And so we think the structure in this dimension of that the structure can be, maybe this building in 20 years won't be a multiplex of cinema. And maybe in 20 years we won't have the use of 11 rooms to see 11 theater rooms to see movies. And maybe in 20 years, the city, the mayor, the new mayor, wanted to make a supermarket or whatever. And the structure has been think now to allow future uses. So maybe, I don't know if it's... What do I think?
What do you think is unique about Paris and France?
What is unique? The Tour Eiffel, of course. Did you come in Paris?
Pardon?
Did you ever, have you been in Paris?
Yeah, once.
Okay. I don't know, you know, I'm born here, I'm born there, so I'm a I know Paris for 40 years now, 48 years. So it's an old friend. I'm so happy when I leave Paris, but I'm so happy each time when I come back. So I don't know. So it's it's a very affective link with Paris and me. But we work with economists. We work with economists from the beginning. So, and now we have a little idea of what it will cost. But from the beginning, from the first weeks of the concourse of the competition, we have economists with us, and I think the question of the cost is one of the angle of the strategy. And when you think in France, because we are not so well known, we are not Swiss, and so we have to deal with low cost. Maybe the low cost of architecture. I don't know. But we have to deal with public money, and because all those projects is made with a public fund, so it's quite a responsibility. For us it's a part of the context of the project. It's a part of the context, so it's like you have a site, you have a cost, and you have technical knowledge at one moment in this town, and so you have to analyze all that, and after you have to make a strategy to be able to make this your building with this contraint, comme on dit,
constraint,
with this constraint. So you see, for example, in Nantes, it's really low cost building. It's very simple. The details are very simple, but it's a work. We work with this. So we work the materiality, the question of materiality. Is integrate integrate this reflection about economy. À combien?
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.